Many of you have bought the MXQ Pro 4K 5G because of its unbelievable low price in the market. Sa halagang 700 pesos or $14, eh meron ka ng device that can turn your ordinary TV into a smart TV. Most of these devices that are sold at this price point ay kadalasan fake camera specs. Meaning to say, nasa 1GB lang talaga ang RAM niyan kahit paano mo pa yan balibalik na rin. Kapalit ng murang halaga nito ay dagdag na problema sa mga users. Naranasan mo na ba na nakailang araw ka pa lang nagamit ang Android box mo bigla na lang itong magbabagal sa hindi may paliwanag na kadahilanan? O di kaya naman bigla na lang itong mag-i-stock sa MXQ Pro or Android na logo after you switch it on? And because of this, hindi mo na ito pwedeng magamit. Ilan lang ang mga yan sa problema ng MXQ Pro. And in this video, I will teach you how to reset your Android box and give it its second life. Hindi naman lahat ng Android box users are highly technical pagdating sa paggamit ng kanilang mga devices. Kaya naman, pagkabili pa lang nila ng device nila, ay diretso na nila itong gagamitin without backing it up. Kaya naman, kapag nagka-issue na ang device nila at di na nila magamit, dalawa lang ang kahantungan yan. Either isosoli ito sa seller, or worst case, i-dispose na lang yan sa basurahan. Sayang naman. Don't worry my friend, there's still a chance para maibalik mo yan sa dati and I will teach you how. This video is applicable in reviving your slow or stuck Android box without your stock or backup image file by simply doing a factory data reset. There are 4 methods on how to reset your device kung wala ka pang backup or stock image file. First is the reset by Android menu. Second is reset by ADB USB. Third is the reset by ADB WIFI. And last but not the least, reset by Toothpick method. The first 3 methods can be performed kung may access ka pa sa Android system ng device mo. In other words, may chance ka pa to navigate through the settings of your device. While the last method or the toothpick method can be performed on devices kung stuck na ang device mo sa MXQ or Android logo. I have tested this with the following devices to ensure that these reset methods really worked. However, as a disclaimer, I don't take any responsibility for any damages done to your device in following these methods. Each Android box chipset may differ from the other and one method may not work for the other. So please, do this at your own risk. Let's begin with the first method or reset by Android menu. This can be simply done by going first to your home screen, then go through your Android settings by clicking the settings icon, navigate to the storage and reset, click factory data reset, confirm this action by clicking factory data reset, and finally, click erase everything. Your system will restart and your device will begin doing the reset process. This will take a few minutes, so I will just fast forward this part of the video. Once done, it will boot to a fresh home screen tulad nung paano nyo siya nabuksan nung bago nyo siyang nabili. As you can see, your device is now fresh as new and tanggal na lahat ng reason sa pagpabagal ng Android box mo. Now we go to the second method or reset by ADB USB. We will be needing the following for this method. A Windows PC or laptop, an ADB or Android debug bridge included in the SDK Android platform tools which needs to be installed in your computer, a micro USB data cable, and a female micro USB to full USB male adapter. First, we need to download to your computer the official SDK platform tools from Android Studio. Launch your internet browser and search for Android platform tools. In the search results, click the link that directs you to developer.android.com to ensure that this is the official software release. you will be taken to Android Studio and click the download link for Windows. Read the terms and conditions and tick the I have read and agree box. Click the download link and wait for the download to finish. Once finished, go to your downloads folder and you will notice that the downloaded file is in zip file. Extract the contents using any data compression software like WinZip or WinRAR. Open the extracted folder and copy all its contents. For the most important part, create a new folder in your C drive and name it ADB. Open the ADB folder and paste all the files you have copied from the Platform Tools folder. Take note of the folder address where you have placed all the files, as this is very important in accessing the ADB file kapag inopen na natin ang command prompt. On your desktop, click the search icon and type CMD to bring out the command prompt application. Click the command prompt application to launch it. Once open, we need to open ADB from its location by typing cd:\adb. You are now ready to use ADB once you see the next line that says c:\adb. Hayaan nyo lang munang naka-open ang command prompt window while we make necessary preparations para ma-connect natin ng maayos ang MXQ Pro sa ating computer without any errors. Ngayon na ipe-prepare natin ang ating device for USB connection. Kakailanganin natin ng isang micro USB data cable. Please note that charge-only cables will not work. For this demo, I will be using my cell phone's data cable, which is also a fast charger cable. Meron siyang full USB sa isang dulo and a micro USB sa kabilang dulo. In order to connect the MXQ Pro using this cable, we will be needing a female micro USB to male full USB adapter na pwedeng bilhin sa mga electronic shops. Naglagay ako ng link sa baba kung saan nyo ito pwedeng mabili online. As an alternative, pwede rin kayong bumili ng full male to male USB cable which will work just fine. Now, we can go ahead and plug the data cable to our device. The other end of the cable will be plugged to our computer or laptop. Next, we need to activate developer options. We can do this by going to your home screen, click the settings icon, select About, go to the Build section, click it multiple times using your remote control until you see a notification that you are now a developer. Go back to the previous menu, click About, and do a restart. Once booted, we need to activate some developer options para ma-recognize ng computer natin yung device natin. We simply go to Settings, head over to Developer Options, activate USB settings to connect to computer, activate USB debugging, and click OK. Next is to select the USB configuration and select MTP or Media Transfer Protocol. While doing this, you will get a notification from your computer that the device has been connected, and it will begin setting it up. wait until the device becomes ready. As a verification that your device is already connected to your PC, you will see in your Windows Explorer that the TV box is already listed in your devices. Next, we go back to our command prompt window and we are now ready to issue command to our Android box. You simply type ADB reboot recovery. Your device will now reboot to recovery. Wait for the Android recovery menus to show up. Using your remote, navigate to Wipe Data or Factory Reset. Click it and select Yes. Data Wipeout will commence. Wait for it to finish. Once completed, navigate to Wipe Cache Partition, then click it, then select Yes. Once done, select Reboot System Now. Your Android box will now do a factory data reset. This will take time, so I will again fast forward this part. Finally, your device is now reset, fresh as new. No slowdowns and everything seems to be working fine. So wakas, na-reset din ang iyong Android box. We can now proceed to the third method or reset by ADB WIFI. We will be needing the following for this particular method: a Windows PC or laptop, ADB or Android debug bridge in our PC or laptop, and lastly, a Wi-Fi connection. Now, the third method is much simpler than the ADB USB. We will be using ADB Wi-Fi. For this case, no USB cables are required. However, a Wi-Fi connection is mandatory. We also need to activate developer options. This procedure was already covered on the second method. Once you already have the developer options, simply go to your device settings, click developer options, and enable Internet ADB. Next, we need to connect our Android box and the computer to the same Wi-Fi network. Unahin muna natin ang Android box. Navigate to the device settings, click network, and connect to your preferred Wi-Fi connection. Enter your password and click next. Once successfully connected, click again on that active Wi-Fi connection and look for the assigned IP address of your Android box. For this case, it's 192.168.0.119. We have to take note of this, kasi kinakailangan natin ito mamaya sa ADB command prompt window. Ang susunod naman nating i-coconnect sa Wi-Fi ay yung computer na paggagamitan natin. Simply right-click on your computer internet connection icon and connect to a Wi-Fi network na kung saan nakakonect din ang Android box nyo. As an important note, make sure na naka-install na rin ang ADB sa computer nyo. This procedure was already covered in the second method, and kapag na-install na ang ADB, launch the command prompt application. Open ADB from its location by typing cd space c colon backslash ADB. This time, we type ADB connect plus the IP address of your Android box, which is 192.168.0.119. Once you receive a positive connection notification, go ahead and type ADB reboot recovery. Your device will now reboot to recovery. Wait for the Android recovery menus to show up. Using your remote, navigate to Wipe Data or Factory Reset. Click it and select Yes. Data Wipeout will commence. Wait for it to finish. Once completed, navigate to Wipe Cache Partition, then click it, then select Yes. Once done, select Reboot System Now. Your Android box will now do a factory data reset. This will take time, so I will again fast forward this part. Your device is now back to its younger self without any issues. Last but not the least is the toothpick method. Ito ay tinawag na toothpick method because it requires you to have a toothpick or any pointed device to be inserted on the AV port of the Android box para mapindot yung reset button. I have opened my MXQ Pro 4K 5G for you to be able to actually see how the reset button looks like. Makikita nyo dito na as we push in the screwdriver through the AV port, mapapansin nyo na napepress din yung reset button ng Android box. With this, nagka-idea na kayo kung ano nga ba ang laman ng MXQ Pro 4K 5G ninyo. Okay, moving along, isa lang naman ang kailangan nyo for this method. You only need a toothpick or any long pointed device kagaya ng precision screwdriver na gagamitin ko ngayon. Make sure that the power supply cord is not connected to the Android box. Then, i-coconnect nyo lang yung HDMI cord na galing sa TV nyo papunta sa MXQ Pro. As for the power supply, iabang nyo lang siya sa power port, pero huwag nyo munang isasaksak. Next, get your precision screwdriver and insert it to the AV port. Itulak nyo siya pababa hanggang maramdaman mo na may magkiklik. Don't release the screwdriver. Hayaan nyo lang siyang nakapress sa reset button. Habang nakapress pa ang reset button, pwede na ngayong isaksak ang power supply. Then begin counting 3 seconds, then tsaka nyo palang i-release yung precision screwdriver. Wait for your device to light up. The light will tell you that your Android box is now rebooting to recovery. Your device will now reboot to recovery. Wait for the Android recovery menus to show up. Using your remote, navigate to Wipe, Data, or Factory Reset. Click it and select Yes. Data Wipeout will commence. Wait for it to finish. Once completed, navigate to Wipe Cache Partition, then click it, then select Yes. Once done, select Reboot System Now. Your Android box will now do a factory data reset. This will take time, so I will again fast forward this part. Finally, your device is now reset, fresh as new. No slowdowns and everything seems to be working fine. Sa lahat ng method, ito ang pinakamadali. But the thing is, hindi sa lahat ng device nagwo-work ito. If it did not work out sa device mo, you may experiment by varying the amount of time you are pressing the reset button after powering up your Android box. So instead of 3 seconds lang, pwede nyong gawing 1 second, or you can hold it for as long as 10 seconds, it's really up to you. Iba-iba kasi ang configuration ng mga Android box, kaya minsan magkakaiba din ang reset button holding time. Ayan! I hope nakatulong ito how to reset your device in various ways sa mga panahong nagbagal or nagstuck ang Android box nyo, especially ang MXQ Pro. Kaya nyo na ngayong i-reset ito in many ways. On my next video, I will teach you how to do a backup image of your Rockchip devices tulad ng MXQ Pro, and how to flash the backup image or any compatible stock ROM to your device, and make it run like new again. Stay tuned to the channel for more helpful videos. Alright, that's it for now. Hanggang sa muli mga ka-frugal, this is Lawrence, and have a good day!